I started in the fishing industry in 1943. I was 17, I think. I was born in Ladner here, and I didn't come down this end until I was in my late teens, but I had all kinds of friends up in Ladner, and that's how I got started in the fishing. A good friend of mine, he's a bit older than me, but he said, I'll give you a skiff and a chunk of net, and he says, you can go out and, for the summer, like you see, in the summer of 1943. And but it was no engine on it or anything. You had to row, or a lot of the guys would tow you back up to the head of the drift, but then you had to row out. And I bought a little boat. We called it the Wedge. That's what it looked like, a wedge. It was about a 24-foot, 26-footer maybe. But it had a single-cylinder Frisbee engine in it. I bought it for $5, the boat and engine. Yeah, I only kept it 1 year, and then following year I went. I had a chance to go seining, so I went seining. I seined 1 year. It was a poor year. I liked seining, but I fell in love with my wife down here, my brother, John's aunt. Yeah. I fell in love with her, and she said that if we weren't going to stay together for a lifetime, she said, I don't want you wandering all over the coast. She said, I don't intend to raise a family by myself. So I said, okay, that's fine with me. And her father, my father-in-law, and he said, well, you can work for me. And I did. I worked for him right till he died, and then I took the business over. Yeah. Anyway, that's how I got into the fish collecting business, and I was never sorry. But I guess the longest and hardest day I had was when I had the big collector, the 40-footer, and I made two loads that day from Canoe Pass around here and then back. I retired from collecting in 1977. That was, I collected from 46 to 77, and then it got so bad that you couldn't afford to keep a boat. So I just had it rebuilt, and so I had a chance to sell it. Had a license on it, so I sold it. It was a job I really, really liked. It was a good life.